St. Petersburg is in mourning over the victims of the recent subway blast. According to the latest information, 11 people were killed in the explosion. 45 injured are now in hospitals. One Belarusian among them. There's no threat to his life. Meanwhile, the driver of the train in whose carriage the explosion took place will be awarded. The Russian Investigative Committee calls the incident a terrorist attack. It's possible that the explosion was carried out by a suicide bomber. Meanwhile, this morning, two subway stations were closed in St. Petersburg due to an unidentified object. After the track, they resumed operation. It was with condolences in connection with the tragedy that the meeting between Vladimir Putin and Alexander Lukashenko began the day before. All integration problems and unresolved issues in the economy fade away in the face of security threats, the president of Belarus stressed. The negotiations lasted for about 5 hours. Speaking of their results, the two leaders emphasized that no outstanding issues were left in the bilateral relations. Mutually beneficial decisions have been made across the whole range of matters. The president confirmed readiness to jointly develop rules for a common gas market by January, and by the 19th of July, the conditions for a common electricity market are to be established. Another important topic was the development of cooperation in the agrarian and industrial spheres. Belarus will train personnel for the Garlyk mining and processing plant. This was stated by the Minister of Education Igor Karpenko. Moreover, the personnel will be trained at both higher and secondary special and vocational schools. Cooperation education between our country and Turkmenistan has been developing for a long time. About 9,000 Turkmen students study at Belarusian universities.